Okay, I think we can start. Welcome again. My name is Giorgio Calculli. I'm in charge of training and member relations areas of ACEMET, the Association of Italian Textile Machinery Manufacturers. Today we are facing the third episode out of six of our webinar series on Italian textile technology. Today's focus is on finishing technologies. Before starting, let me give the floor to Alex Zucchi, the president of ACEMET, for a brief greeting. Please, Alex.
Hello to everybody. Assalamu alaikum. Unfortunately, 1 month back when we start this series of webinars, we had some connection problems. So I take the chance today to thank all the people that has contributed to make this technological center in Faisalabad possible. So starting from the local NTU University in the person of its rector and our local ambassador and Italian Trade Agency. Without the support of Italian Trade Agency, everything was really almost impossible to be realized. When almost 3 years back we start this project, we aim to achieve a certain goal, to prepare the next generation of management of people that is going to manage all the textile company in Pakistan can learn about the Italian technology. Italian technology is well known worldwide. Everybody knows the high level of our quality, of our creativity. And we collect in our association, ACEMET, most of all the best Italian textile machinery manufacturer. ACEMET is the third largest organization in the world with over 2 billion euro sales. Out of that, 85% is exported in over 130 countries. Pakistan is one of our major destinations, particularly in the last year, where the local government is supporting strongly the textile industry. And as Italian, we are ready to support all your industry and all your company. So today, you will assist and follow one section of the complete chain of the textile, particularly finishing, probably the largest sector of the complete chain. And you, I'm sure you will enjoy some interesting presentation that is divided in two parts, because next week also, I think, Giorgio, you can correct me, we'll get a second section again of finishing. And feel free to make any comment. Also, video presentation will be made available through our office. And I'm sure all, particularly for the student, you learn that nothing comes for casualty. So the level achieved by the Italian manufacturer is because behind there is a strong history, a strong development, research and development, and more of that, there is also long, long experience. And am I used to say everybody?
Non ti sentiamo, Alex. There is a technical problem, I think, I suppose. Alex?
Non so se era andato il microfono, adesso dovrebbe essere di ritorno.
Ti sentiamo.
Ok. So I simply wish to everybody to enjoy the today presentation. Thanks. Okay.
Thanks, Alex. Let's move on. Today we have four Italian textile machinery manufacturers, Mario Crosta, Ferraro, Lipe, Salvadè, that are going to show us the excellence of their production in the field of technologies for finishing. Before giving the floor to the first speaker, I just would like to share two small notes. This webinar, like previous one, is recorded, as mentioned before. The recording will be shared with the National Textile University, which will make it available to its students or guests. Anyone wishing to ask questions can post them in the chat room that I think is available at the bottom of the screen. And the speaker will answer at the end of the today's four presentation. Okay, we have finally reached the time for the company presentation. The first panelist is Mr. Roberto De Grandi of Mario Crosta. Roberto De Grandi, graduated in electronic engineering, has been sales director in Mario Crosta since 2008. He has acquired long experience, especially on Asian market. He has matured in many years high technical preparation on wet and dry finishing processes, especially on raising, shearing, and sweeting. Please, Roberto, you are kindly requested to come on stage.
Okay. Dear all, dear friend, thank you very much for being here. I really appreciate your interest toward all our teams. And I'm here to introduce Mario Crosta, what is making in terms of finishing machinery, and what is the presence of Mario Crosta in Pakistan, which is actually really strong in all the parts of Pakistan. Especially in Faisalabad area, we are very strong, especially for on textile producer, but also on knit, like name like Kamal, Lahore, and so on. Therefore, I want to introduce what we do. Okay, do you see?
See.
Okay. Second, that I don't know why this disappear. Okay. Okay. Mario Crosta is one of the oldest company manufacturing finishing machine in Italy. We are almost 100 years that we are producing raising machine, shearing machine, and sweating machine. Our background is mainly on the surface finishing of the fabric. Therefore, we are able to introduce many machines with a long, long experience and with a long, long time and highest number of machines installed over the world, in order to give to the customer the highest background and the highest knowledge about what we can propose. As I told you, Mario Crosta is a company that has been established in 1925. Is a family-owned company. The company has been established by Mr. Mario Crosta, who is the grandfather of the nowadays managing director. After this, followed his son, Mr. Emanuele Crosta, that gave to the company the highest number of presence all over the world. And nowadays, we are managed by the three sons of Emanuele, Marco, Massimo, and Laura, that has taken care about the service, management, and production. Our company has a long experience in manufacturing, but has a long experience in engineering. I mean, all our machine comes from a deep study about how to improve all the single part of the machine, the mechanical, the electronic, and so on. Our company has a big network. We have after-sales service everywhere, mainly, Bangladesh, India, Egypt, Brazil, and so on. In Pakistan, we have our after-sales service located in Karachi, together with our agent, which is Mustex Corporation. Start with what we can propose. We mainly produce a raising machine, shearing machine, and sweating machine. Starting from raising machine, we can propose a single drum raising machine. We are very well known for the production of Polar. Consider that Polar fleece has been invented 30 years ago by a US company, Malden Mills, together with the background and the technical knowledge of Mario Frost. So we are proposing our Polar fleece line, considering raising, combing, and shearing, to all the major producer of Polar fleece and all the major sub-supplier for Polar fleece and user, like Decathlon, Puma, or what else. A machine where we are very, very, very strong is the double drum raising machine for knit. This machine, we have more than 500 numbers installed over the world. And especially in this period in which, due to COVID, everyone is wearing fleece, we are producing a huge number of this machine. For instance, this machine is going to reach Faisalabad in a very short time to Kamal Textile, which is one of the biggest producer of knit in your area. We are also strong in machine for automotive, the same raising machine, but with a different geometry, with a different behavior, and of course with a different duty, because the fabric is completely different and the process is completely different. In terms of woven, we are very strong as well, and we produce a double drum or single drum machine, which are both used for apparel or for home textile. Especially for home textile, Pakistan is one of the biggest market in the world, producing flannel, producing towel, producing bed sheet, and so on. And in Pakistan, we are very, very strong. Consider that our biggest customer that we have in Pakistan is Sadakat, which is located in Faisalabad. They're using more than 12 machines from us. Another very important customer that we have in Faisalabad is Crescent, which is producing a very good flannel fabric and so on. Otherwise, big presence in Karachi area with Al Karam, Gulamed, all the major producer of flannel. We want to point out that raising machine, there are many, many, many different models, depending on the geometry and depending on the numbers of raising rollers that you are using. Starting from knit, where you are using a small drum with 24 cylinder, going up to the flannel or the moleskin, where you need a big drum using 36 cylinder. Every time we have to analyze what kind of fabric, what is the target of the customer, what is the real surface process that is interested to do. And on the basis of that, we understand which is the right machine for supplying to him, and in order to highlight the biggest possibility, not only in terms of quality, but in terms of productivity, because of course our machine must be running something around 25-30 meters per minute, giving a huge production capacity. In terms of woven, we have the possibility of producing, on proposing to the customer, the single drum or the double drum. Consider that the difference is just only for the space to be used, because many of our customers have problems of space. Therefore, using a double drum gives the possibility of sparing space and optimizing the presence of the machine at its finishing mill. This is a typical example of a double drum 36 cylinders installed. The production of this machine is huge. It's a big castle producing a lot of fabric, giving the highest quality and the highest productivity that you can find on the market. Passing now to another kind of machinery, we're talking about shearing machine. Also in this case, shearing machine, there are many, many, many possibilities, many, many models, because we have model for knits, we have model for woven, we have model for flannel, we have model for blanket, we have model for terry towel, and so on. Therefore, also in this case, the first thing to be understood is the target of the customer, what he needs to do, the productivity that he needs to have, the quality that he needs to have, and so on. We start from the cherry machine for knit. Typical use of this is cotton plush, baby wear, polar fleece, or to equalizing the classical cotton fleece or three-thread fleece. Therefore, this usually machine is posed on a small working width, we are talking about 2.4 meter, and has some device that are very specialized for opening the knit, opening the selvage, treating the fabric in order to give it too much tension, because the problem of working with the knit is the tension that you're giving it during your process. Therefore, there is a lot of parts in our machine that are used for assuring and guaranteeing the right treatment of the fabric and the right treatment of the tension of the fabric alongside the complete process. Shearing machine for woven is different because, first of all, the inlet and the outlet are different. One is for pallet, this is from roll, and so on. But the peculiarity of this fabric is different from the other one. Therefore, we cannot give one machine that is suitable for any kind of fabric. Every machine must be studied and given the right devices together in order to optimize the efficiency of the machine on that kind of fabric. Also in this case, we are producing and we are proposing to the customer small working width when they're making apparel shearing. But we are proposing big working width when they're making home textile. Consider that the same machine can be manufactured from 1,800 mm working width till 3,600 mm working width. And you understand that making a small machine is different from making a big machine because there are a lot of tension to be considered. There is a lot of flexion of the cylinder to be considered. The uniformity of the action to be done on the surface in order to have difference between center and selvage of let or what else. Therefore, this machine, even if appears similar to the other one, to tell the truth, is completely different. And okay, the shearing head will be the same, but all the rest, how to manage the machine, is really different. That's the reason why I say, if you need one machine, you have to understand exactly what you want to do on the machine. Even on the same woven fabric, there are differences, because depending by the effect that you want, you have to use more blades or less blades, different treatment or what else, in order to focus exactly on the model that is suitable for it. A model where we are very, very, very strong, and in Pakistan, we have very sounding name like Al-Karam Towel, like Feroz, like Sadakat, and what else, is the machine for terry towels. Terry towels has a peculiarity. Need to be shared in a certain way in order to have all the loops of the terry towel equalized on shearing. Because if you don't make the right equalization of these loops, the aspect of your fabric will be not uniform. Therefore, you need to prepare the loops to be cut before going onto the shearing. If you see on the machine, first of all, you are passing through some steam, because the steam is very important in order to soften the fabric and having all the loops well equalized. The most important thing is this cylinder, which is a cylinder with blades and R, which is called rotor, which is a cylinder that is used for rising up all the loops so that all the loops equalized before go on additional velveting brush that is cleaning the fabric, still revivating the loops, beating on the back in order to have the maximum uniformity of the fabric on the back, and going to shearing. But as you can See, the sharing is just only the last part of that. Because if you're not preparing with Steam, with the Proto or what else, your quality will not enough, will be not the right one that is requested for having a perfect uniformity of the surface of the fabric. As I told you, all the bigger producer of terry towels in Pakistan, in India, in Portugal, and so on, are using this machine because it's the machine that is giving the highest flexibility, the highest quality, and also the highest productivity in such a kind of product. Okay, on textile, very strong for the production of curtains, for the production of embroidery, for the production of all the light fabric that are typical for the home textile. In this case, we have to cut the backside of the fabric where there is a lot of loosened yarn that are to be opened and then to be cut. And we are using a loosened yarn, which is very small. We have to open before being the machine and then to be cut the back. Having some other devices for equalizing the tension between the center and the selvage, or between the right and the left set, in order to have maximum uniformity of cut over there. Also, this machine is very well known all over the world, all the producer of curtains, all the producer of embroidery or jacquard fabric are know very well this machine, because we use this machine working with 3 meter 60. 3 meter 60, you need some technologies. If you have some bends of the cylinder or some not perfect equalization of the sharing cylinder, you will not obtain maximum of the quality that you're looking for. Apart from that, we have also other shearing machines that are typical for wool or polyester viscose. We have in 2 heads, 3 heads, double back, front, and so on, which are typical machines for wool industry. In Pakistan, there is not a big issue for such a kind of machinery. Another machine which is very important for the home textile, when you're producing velvet, to have a shearing machine that is also equipped with the glossy possibilities, shining per there. This machine is working with the blade cylinder heated at 220 degrees in order to give the right shining effect, especially if you're working with viscose or polyester and so on. This is the typical machine for home textile when you're working with velvet. So as well, we have complete line for velvet producing in jacquard, where the fabric comes out with some design that are to be equalized and are to be cut. Also in this case, we have a long line with coagulation, steaming, thermal tiger in order to uniform the pile, and then going up to another rotor for shining effect, and then to cut. This is the typical line used on the jacquard fabric of a Van de Ville looms or what else. Another section where we are very, very strong is the swathing machinery. We have swathing both for knit, for woven, for small working weave, for big working weave, and so on. This machine is very well known in Pakistan, where we have this machine present in Gulamed, in Crescent, in Sadakat. One machine is reaching Lahore fashion in these days. And this is a machine typical for having the peach skin effect, which is an effect that is mostly required in this period for giving this soft end to the fabric that you are wearing, or to the fabric of home textile like bed sheet or what else. Also in this case, we have a machine for knit, which is having the same heart, but different solution in preparation of the fabric, having spreaders, having knit spreaders like the Tandematic and so on, because the same problem of NIT processing is also affecting this machine. So we need to well open the NIT without giving too much tension. Otherwise, we will have selvage curling, too much relaxation of the fabric, and so on. This is the old model that we were proposing before the LISA, but still is required because since
sorry,
it's
Roberto,
a machine.
I ask you to finish. This.
20 the minutes, you said.
The time is over.
Okay, so okay, 3 minutes I finish. Okay, also in this case, woven the same similar machine, but different action. So on, just to reach the big working width, which is used for the bed sheet, that is in this very moment is very requested. Okay, so a last machine that I'm proposing to you, which is typical for the apparel product, is the diamond emery, which is very, very used for bottom wear, trousers or jacket or what else. Okay, this is a typical fashion requirement that year after year are requested a lot or not. Like brush suading, diamond emery is something related to the vague of the moment, to the fashion of the moment. But in this moment, they are very, very strong. And in Pakistan, we are selling this kind of machine. Okay, finish with some machine for wool. Surely are not of interest for you. Just only want to highlight the fact that we have many patent pendings on our machine, like the DC bus that reducing really a lot the power consumption of the machine, like the integrated electronic, the Industry 4.0, so on. And with this, I say it's finished. And now I think it's better pass the voice to the one after us. Would like to thank you very much for the attention. If you have any question, you can contact me on chat. I hope to be as much as clear as possible in order to give an idea about the possibility that Mario Crosta can give your market. Thank you very much for your listening. Thank you very much for your attention.
Thank you, Roberto, for your presentation. It's time for the second company involved in our webinar, Ferraro. The representative is Mr. Alex Zucchi. Let me share a short profile of him. Mr. Alex Zucchi, over 40 years working in textile field, is shareholder and managing director of Ferraro, worldwide leader in finishing machineries. Is managing director of Interfinish, a subsidiary of Ferraro, providing component for textile and aerospace industry. Is president of Acimit, board member of CIMATEX, the European Association of Textile Machinery Manufacturers, and board member of Federmacchine, the Italian Federation of Association of Manufacturers of Capital Goods and Ancillary Products. Please, Alex, come on stage. It's your turn.
Okay. Good morning to everybody again. Let me share the... Okay, one second, where is it? Okay. Is it okay, Giorgio?
Okay.
Okay. Once again, good morning to everybody. Okay, now I will make presentation of few of our machinery. This week, during this webinar, we will introduce the, let's say, the woven section of the production of our company. And next week, well, my colleague will introduce Ferraro company related to the knitted section part of our production. I said before that behind each Italian company, there is a lot to say about. So we cannot achieve the quality of the Italian machinery if behind there are not some fixed point. Innovation and sustainable technology are two of them. They are two very important points on which as Ferraro and also the other Italian machinery, they are focused. Without innovation and without thinking to develop sustainable technology, there is no future. So this is very important, particularly for the student that today they are following all our presentation. Keep in mind that without innovation and without thinking about the sustainable technology, there is no future in any field, and not only textile machinery, particularly in textile, because Pakistan is a huge country for textile. All our machinery, they are certified with the green level, so because we care about the environment. Our company is also certified with all the ISO 9001, 40001, 18001. And obviously, we don't miss also the solution for Industry 4.0. This is also a very important point on which all our associates must be focused on. 4.0 will give us a great future because it will allow us to get the control and the service directly from our main factory. And let's say that it's just starting right now. Particularly, we are working on the predictive maintenance. That means all our machinery will be linked directly with our main service in Italy, and we'll be able to monitor all the machinery 24 hours a day, preventing any time off of the machine. Obviously, behind there is also a big investment in research and development. And this is something that I also mentioned before, without the skilled people, we are not able to produce good machinery. So experience is something that is inside our DNA. It is something that we care about. The capital of our company, it's our people. Obviously, also the machinery, they are built in a way that at any time machine can be expanded. So it's modularity. It's a key point of all Ferraro machinery. And obviously, service. Service, particularly now linked with the project of Industry 4.0, it's something that the customer, all the customer, has the obligation to require to all the manufacturer. And it's not only on online service that now is, let's say, represent still 70-80% of all our service, but the predictive maintenance together with augmented reality, it's something on which we are working on. And in a very short time, we'll be ready to supply all the machinery properly designed and equipped with all the connection to allow us to provide this kind of new digitalized service. Today, as I told you, I want to introduce two lines. One is related to the oven sulfurizing, and the second one is related to the washing. Pakistan is, let's say, popular. It's one of the largest manufacturer of home textile, and we introduce this part of the textile chain in 2006, so it's over 15 years now that we are producing machinery for the finishing of oven line, particularly in Pakistan for bed sheet. This is a typical design, but this is not a fixed machine. It is designed according to the customer requirement. This is a simple example. I give you another example. This is, for instance, another design that we have also in Pakistan, designed for denim. As you may see, there is a huge difference in between a standard machine for garments fabric to another one designed for denim. I don't want to mention that much technically because it will require too much time, but this is just to give an idea that about what can be done, what can be designed. I want to show you also a brief video that you can see a machine, how physically it appears. Oops, sorry. started or not. So, no music. Okay, this is a typical design. You may see there is introduction, J-box, and the heart of the machine, that is the sumphorizer. And obviously, after the sumphorizer, there is the panel where the fabric is finished and fixed. As you may see, machine is always a big size machine, because also productivity required in Pakistan is quite big. There are obviously few details, as you may see, drying, cooling cylinder, and obviously the A-frame at the exit. This kind of machine, generally, they are running in between 40 to 80 meters per minute, so allowing a very, very high production. And each single detail is carried by Ferraro. There is nothing left to the imagination. So everything is designed according customer requirement, because not everybody has the same requirement. So this is a typical one. This is the one that we recently delivered exactly to Karachi. This is, for example, is designed for gabardine to make pants, but the same customer now is installing a new machine from our side, 3.4 meter working with design for bed sheet and printed fabric. Well, I think we can go further. Okay. Let's say so something briefly about also the washing. We develop a particular technology, always focus on saving of energy, water, and avoiding huge pollution. It's a particular design where with a very small amount of water, we can grant a very intensive washing of the fabric. We've considered that each section is around 250 liters, and we make the job of a line of 2000 liters, the standard one. So in a very short space, we are capable to wash the fabric many times. I can show you briefly how. You see there is this particular bar with the spray that washes directly on the fabric. And this variable spray, imagine, can make up to 500 pulls per minute. So in this way, then I show you an animation so you can better understand. This is very good also for students. We are able to wash at each movement, at each pulse, up to 100 millimeters of the fabric, up to five times while the fabric is passing in front. Okay. Should be also some sound, but I cannot hear Giorgio. I don't know if you are hearing or not.
No, vediamo, ma non sentiamo.
The sound is gone. Okay. You see, this is the pattern that I was mentioned before. The unit, it can be managed according to the kind of fabric, and the operator establish how many pulls per minute. So in a very compact space, we are able, imagine, in one section like this, we can wash the same, each single point of fabric up to 40 times. So instead to get a big machine with a big amount of water, we drastically reduce the space and also the consume of water and then the related chemicals. Obviously the complete line is also equipped with the self-cleaning filter. So basically we just remove the dirty part of the water and the water is recycled and reused inside the same machine. Since I want to give the right time to all my colleagues, I think we can go further and show you also a real line while working. So as it appears, because animation is one thing, machine is another story. You may see. This is a typical washing for, I think this is a reactive. Can be made in multiple sections. I think this unit is 7 or 8 different tanks with the relaxing belt as well. You see? This is basically how a machine appears in the reality. I just go a little bit further, so I think this may be interesting, but all these documents will be also supplied directly to Assimit, so everybody can use it. Well, let's go. Obviously, all these machines that we have seen, they are all designed in order to respect the environment. This is an important point that while today all the students will take over the company, will be the next generation management, has to keep in mind always when you are evaluating to make an investment in machinery, keep in mind that the machinery has to respect few important points to prevent future depollution and grant to the future generation a better world. This is an important point. Now, I hope my Urdu is good. I simply thank everybody, and then somebody can tell me if I make a good translation or not. Thank you very much, everybody.
Thanks, Alex, for your interesting explanation. Now let's move on to the third company presentation. Now we have LIPE. His representative is Mr. Massimo Beccheri. Mr. Massimo Beccheri is the president of LIPE, that has been producing dime machines since 1958. LIPE exports its products all around the world. It is located in Prato, one of the biggest textile area in the world. As a typical Italian medium-sized company, LIPE is a family company founded by Mr. Beccheri's father. Now Mr. Beccheri and his brother are running the company. So please, Massimo, you are kindly requested to take the floor. Non ti sentiamo.
Thank you for the introduction, and a special thanks to all the guests participating to this web seminar. For the introduction, LIPE is specialized in dime machines, and we are focused to promote and to develop technology for medium-high fabric sector. As everybody knows, nowadays a lot of cells are in the sector of active wear, sportwear, and for this reason, my speech will be focused on a dime machine suitable for this kind of fabrics. LIPE was founded in 1958, as was told by our fathers, and we are running the company. We are exporting approximately 70% of our production. The world consumption of sports and active clothing is increasing day by day, and the margin of the manufacturer of this type of fabric are undoubtedly higher than the basic commodities like a polo shirt and fleece. I want to say that with our technology, we give the chance to our customer to approach a sales market higher than the basic market, that is the polo shirt, the fleece, and in order to give a head value to the garments or to the fabric produced by our customer. We think that we have to improve the quality. From our side, as a machine producer, we improve the quality of the dyeing machine, the technology of dyeing, and we believe that even our customer has to improve the quality and to approach markets that can grant a high margin compared with standard commodities. And for this reason, I am proposing you a machine that at the moment is very, has a good market, let's say has a good market in the field of warp knit and tubular knit in the dyeing of synthetic fabric, like nylon lycra with 30% lycra or polyester lycra with 10-12% lycra. This kind of fabric are more and more common in the market. If everybody goes to the mall, we can see Calzedonia shops, Nike, and a lot of sportswear, activewear, or leggings are sold in this kind of sector. But to dye this kind of fabric, it will be needed a special dyeing machines. And we are proposing a horizontal dyeing machine. Of course, frankly speaking, we have to say that the liquid ratio is higher compared with round type machines. This is clear. But the quality of the horizontal jet dyeing compared with the round type is incredibly higher. And this is the reason why we can dye this very difficult fabric, like fabric nylon spandex with 30% or 35% lycra. One of the issue of the particularity of this machine is the low tension in the fabric. You can see here there is the reel, here is the containing chamber. There is no tension on the fabric. No tension on the fabric means, thanks to the stainless steel complete reel, we avoid the marks and we avoid the abrasion, especially on the polyester and on the nylon surface. Here is the bottom design of the machines. The fabric pass from the jet, from the nozzle. The fabric pass from the nozzle here, and then enter this kind of tube. And then at this stage here, there is a special design where the fabric, the rope is open. So it passed from a rope, a closed rope, and then it opens and deposited here on the containing chamber. Thanks to this design, we avoid the vertical crease marks that are very dangerous, let's say, for the fabric, on the especially on the warp and on the knit, on synthetic fiber, synthetic fabrics. The management of this machine is very simple. You just set on the controller the quantity of meter, the laps to go, and then the machine automatically runs. There are no butterfly valves, there are no special regulation, and but thanks to the controller, all the phases of the dyeing process, all the phases of the running of the fabric is automatically. And if the fabric run perfectly into the dyeing machine, the quality of the dyeing is perfect. The machine can be usually coupled in tandem. This is a 400 kilo and another 400 kilo where we can run 800 kilo single color or two different colors of 400 kilo each. There is a possibility also to close one tube, and the 400 kilo can work with 200 kilo with the same liquid ratio. So the conclusion for this, we designed this machine to facilitate the operator job. That is, it's a very simple adjustment by the PC. And we avoid, as I mentioned, the crease marks on the the crease marks on the fabric, and also we avoid the problem of the abrasion on the fabric. The results that the top leader in the world that are producing warp and knit fabric from synthetic, from South America, Italy, India, in Vietnam are using our jet 250. These are some installation, of course. Also, our production includes also some dime machine or yarn printing machine. This is a very very famous machine that a lot of customers nowadays are approaching space dime. We have a space dyeing plant in Bangladesh a lot. We have space dyeing in India also. Mostly of them are knitters or upholstery producer. Or even on the terry. This is the effect of the space dyeing on the terry. Again, this is not as a commodities. But this kind of fabric has to reach a higher market, a higher level market on the sales. The machine is completely different from the standard that you can find in the market. And this is, it works by needles and by hydraulic pneumatic pump that inject the colors from the color tank, four color tank, one tank for each colors, directly by the this suction pump from the color tank directly to the needles, and the needles goes inside the cones and spray the dye stuff coming from the dye kitchen with this pump, hydraulic pump, up to 20 bar. To have the perfect and uniformity effect both on the external side and on the internal side. Then we have also a vacuum pump that allow the dye stuff to penetrate it inside the cones. As I mentioned, the machine has a completely stainless steel automatic color kitchen with automatic temperature control, automatic mixing, automatic washing. So this machine grants the repeatability of the effect for every lot. From the first kilo to the last kilo, you are sure that thanks to this machine, you grant the same effect and the same shade. This is one plant in Bangladesh. Also, we produce a yarn dye machine on cones. This is some schematic view. And we have technology to reduce the liquid ratio, improving the density of the packages. Because everybody knows the liquid ratio is a relation between the volume of the key that is fixed. Everybody can play with this kind of mathematics formula. But the liquid ratio is the volume of the gear divided the kilo inside. But as the volume of the gear is fixed, the only way to reduce the liquid ratio is increasing the kilo inside. And increasing the kilo means increasing the density of the packages. And increasing the density of the packages, it will be needed a very special pump, a centrifugal pump with a high power, high performance in terms of capacity and in terms of pressure. This is a special machine we sold years ago in Germany, and you can read on the flow meter, you can read the 50,000 liter per minute. Of course, this is a special application, but 50,000 liter per minute. It was requested a 200 kilowatt pump. If you want to reach this kind of performance, you need a centrifugal pump with, of course, a low, with a high kilowatt. This is a pump with the impeller of 500 millimeters diameter. So to grant, to be sure that we have a very good leveling effect from inside outside, we need a centrifugal pump. We need a special kind of pump, and design of the piping. Design of the piping is really important to avoid the loss of capacity of the pump. As you see, there are a lot of curves here on the dyeing machine. This reduce at the minimum the loss in the circuit. So the combination of the centrifugal pump and the design of the piping allow our customer to have a good and level effect on the cones, even with high density, 400 grams, even 550 grams cones per liter. And thanks to the centrifugal pump, of course, we can reduce the kilowatt, because the performance of this kind of pump are comparable with the handmade pumps. Let's see. This is the system to reverse from inside to outside, outside, inside. We strongly believe that to get a good uniformity inside the cones, you need a two-way pump. Inside, outside, and outside, inside. This is our belief. Of course, we produce also the classic centrifugal pump that we did inside, and the application of this pump are for the fiber dyeing and for the toe dyeing. Of course, full automation, differential delta P, also external heat exchanger for heating and cooling. And thanks to the HT drain stock tank, we can do a fast reactive dyeing according to the quality you need, of course. Because for dyeing, it need time and it needed water, of course. The machine has a completely safety device to avoid the possibility to open the lid when the machine is working in under pressure version. These are some plants all around the world. We have some plant in Karachi, also in Feroz, for fiber dyeing. These are some installations. We produce also horizontal yarn dyeing machines. This is some photos. And we produce also full plant for fiber dyeing from the wet press to the final baling press, passing through the hydro extractor, passing through the cake opener, the hot air dryer. We, thanks with the collaboration with our supplier, we can supply the full line in these fields. So of course I will be available for any question you and for any more clarification you need, and in the meantime I thank you for the attention. Thank you, everybody. Thank you.
Thanks to Roberto. Thanks for the important insight into dyeing technologies. It's time for the last company presentation of today's webinar. I will ask to Mr. Mario Bruno to take the floor for his presentation. Please, you are kindly requested to. Non ti sentiamo.
Do we meet? Okay.
Okay.
Wait a second, because I don't understand why. Questo lo chiediamo. Questo lo chiediamo. possibile. Incredibile, era qua fino adesso. Mi si è bloccato Zoom, questo è il problema.
Prova a uscire e rientrare.
Porco, ok, non mi serve bene. Ok, adesso sono dentro. Wait a second, non capisco perché non mi apra lo schermo.
We have some technical problem with Salvador presentation.
Hold on a second. Hold on a second.
We are competent to solve it.
Ok. Tu devi fare anche la presentazione mia o no? Devi dirgli...
Sì, sì.
Ok.
Mister...
Si vede adesso?
Sì. Mr. Mario Bruno, Sales Director of Salvadè, manufacturer of machines for printing and finishing sector. He is working since 1997 in the textile sector, always in the sales, but with a strong attitude and technical background. Within this period, he could develop experiences in fabric printing and finishing and yarn dyeing. Please.
Thank you. First of all, good afternoon to everybody. Thank you very much for attending this webinar with us. My presentation will be a little bit more technical than the other one. And I hope that it will be useful for you guys that are attending course in the university. So we go straight forward to the company. This is a typical Italian company, as my colleague said to you. So it was a company founded by just a small family, and we are 49 people. And basically we are concentrated in engineering on everything we produce. And then we use the outsourcing, which in Italy is a very strong sector, to help us to build up the machine. And the main reason of success, I think this is very important to say, because it's valid for everybody that was here in the webinar, is the point number two, which we used to work in partnership with highly demanding customers located here. I mean, here in Italy, we have still now a very strong sector in textile, and this helped us a lot. I mean, every one of us has the challenge every day to solve the problem of our customers, that they serve, that they produce fabric for the high fashion sector, the very demanding sector. So when you are able to solve this problem day by day, for sure you can present around the world machines that for sure they can be able to solve your problem too. We have personally here in Salvador, we're highly specialized in steaming after printing, and of course we have another sector, which is dryers, but is not the focus of this presentation. The presentation is the after printing machine steamer that we produce since 39 years now. So important to focus which are the market trends now. So the printing changed a lot at the beginning of this millennium. We were in the previous. The majority was in Italy, I mean, I'm talking. It's still in the world, still you have a lot of rotary printing and flat printing, what we call conventional printing. But consider that now, for instance, in my country, which is the biggest country in terms of printing in the world, we have more than 68% now is digital printing. Digital printing is now expanding all over the world, and in Pakistan too, a lot. And producers like Reggiani, MS, and other people, and Konica, other Japanese, are really invading the market, because what the customer now needs is high quality, a continuous change in the drawing and in the design and the customization. So they need just in time, right first time. So the digital printing is exactly the solution. And many people is moving now from the old rotary printing that probably will remain just for big production to the digital printing. Digital printing implies in the fixation more problem that our steamer is able to solve. So this is just an example, a couple of pictures about a typical digital printing machine. And this is the steamer. This is the steamer, which is quite a big machine. And this is what I would say, as Mr. Calculi said, I spent the last 23 years in this sector and I never found the machine so critical in the process. I mean, when I was working just for your example, for example, in Hyundai, if you miss, if you're not able to get the correct color, you have, always have the chance to bleach it and to at least to dye black and send it as a second choice. But when when the fixation in the steamer is not well done, you throw away everything. There's no way back in the printing. You can have the best preparation, the best printing machine, but if the fixation of the color is not well done, when you get out, you discover this after washing, and then you throw everything away. Trash, completely. So this is a really critical machine. And the mechanically speaking, not that difficult machine to be, but thermodynamically, this is a really a sophisticated machine, because in this big box, consider this is a machine of containing 450 meters of fabric, and is a machine which is about 12 meter long, about 4.5 meter high, and about 4.5 meter width. So can you imagine the cubic meter you have inside? And the secret is to keep an atmosphere with a saturated steam, exactly with the same content of water and exactly the same temperature, 24 hours a day, in every one of the cubic meter of this volume. This is really a difficult task to be achieved. This is a section of the machine we have inside of our catalog, where you can appreciate our system of double chains. And this is a picture as an overlook of the steamer inside. Now, this is, I don't have enough time to go deep inside of this discussion, because I need more or less 40 minutes just to explain the machine inside. We have 20 minutes only. So of course I need to go fast here. But anyway, this is an overlook of the machine where you can see the, the double chain system. You can see the ventilator in order to move the steam in the machine. And you need our double wall technology, the differentiate us from everybody. We insulate completely. The fabric is inside the machine from outside world. So this is what, this is very important. I mean, what changed in the at the beginning of the millennium with the digital printing? Many people were saying, I already have a steamer, so I go to digital and I just change the printing machine. But this is really wrong. Why? With the fabric preparation for the digital, we need much more urea than what you need for the conventional printed. And that when you have the urea on the fabric, the possibility to replicate the color on the printed face is very high. So what we have tried to do is to change this situation with our machine. So this table shows what happened in the steamer. In the steamer, we have a table here where you have in the first column the fibers, in the second the dye stuff that you use, and this is the dwell time. So the time the fabric has to spend inside of the machine to be fixed. And then you have the temperature. Of course, it's a range. Range depends on the fabric, depends on the coverage of printing. And this is to be the printing master would decide how to set up the machine. Then you have the presence of steam, yes or no. If you look at the end, you have pigmentation, which is a polymerization, you don't need any steam. And then you have, if you need the machine, high temperature or not. Of course, for disperse on polyester and pigment, you need the machine able to get up to 170 Celsius degrees. The secret is to keep, during all the dwell time, the same atmosphere, the same environment inside of the machine. So, as I say here in this slide, it was more or less, it was 2006 when Nomega is a company very close by here in Como, a famous printing company in north of Italy, faced for the very first time the digital matter. Apple found out of that, that the VPN model already has been already designed with a solution unbelievably perfect to solve the problem that you have on the digital printing. So we can identify 5 points which made the success of this machine in the last 15 years. So the uniform motion of the loops inside of the machine, a video that I will show you afterwards, we show you this. So the loop of the fabric inside of the machine will move in a constant way. They will not shake. So they will not touch. The two printed face, they will not touch, avoiding the replication. And the inlet of the fabric, by means of the fiberglass covered by and motorized cylinder, the formation is made by the own weight of the fabric. So there is no fluctuation, no oscillation by a big jet of overheated steam. In our case, the jet of overheated steam at the end just helps to create a very soft loop in, and always to avoid to touch. This is very important. The fabric rods in our machine are independent on the, of the chain. So you can move it manually, taking out and doubling the distance between the loop in order for the very, very light fabric. Again, you keep a very safe distance between the two printed faces of the fabric in order, again, to avoid any possible contamination or replication by the contact of the two faces. Then a patented system, super wet, is what they really, what they told you before was already in the machine since ever. But the point number four is that the super wet system is a system which is able to keep. We guarantee maximum 0.2, a range of 0.2 Celsius degrees within the 24 hours. Remember, this is a atmospheric machine. This is not a pressure machine. So the saturation of the steam and the pressure of the steam is the pressure is what you have where you are depending on the altitude on the sea level. And this is only the temperature which determine the quantity of water you have inside, because you cannot play with the pressure. It's not a pressurized machine. So when you keep the temperature within a certain very, very short range, narrow range, you sure you keep the you keep the saturation as has to be. And this is what the super wet is designed for. Then very important for who treats needs. The needs is that remember in the steamer, you don't have any pin chain. You don't have anything like the stator frame. So with the rotation, you have a very high possibility that the selvages of the knitted fabric start to curling. So we, in the point number five, we patented the system which you can control the rotation. You can minimize the rotation of the rods in order to avoid this curling of the selvages. This is very important. So let's show you the video of what happened when we formed the loop inside of the machine. And you can see that here, you can see that the rods are moving completely constantly. You see, there is no any shaking. Look, the animation shows you. So the double chain system permits you to move constantly the loop. This is what happened. And here on the side, you have these systems. So the stick, the rods goes from one chain drop to the other one. This is the secret of, this is what is the solution that comes that make possible, you know, a completely zero touch during the old processes. This is a small picture that showing you this chain, which was the fast chain. And this is the chain that actually keep the loop for the dwell time inside of the machine. Yeah, you see here again, you see it's completely constant. The speed of the chain is completely constant. So you see now the fab is getting out. And this is very important. You see that the stick is completely independent of the rod. An operator take get them out to make maintenance of something. Or, you see, very easy to take it out. Nothing to be dismounted. Of course, we develop, especially for the Italian market where we have a very small loss, the possibility to have an automatic, yeah, we'll see now, an automatic download and upload of the key of the rod. Look at that. This system, take out the rod, put here, store here, and then this one will go. So if you want to go for 100 millimeter distance to 200 millimeter distance, you store every two, you put one in a store. You see here, this is very important when you go to viscose below 120 GSM. You don't want to have any risk that the two faces touch one each other. This is the super wet system. This graph tells you what happened with the super wet. With the super wet, you can keep completely constant Y102, normally 102, what we set up for a super high fixation of reactive dyne on cotton, which is very common there in your country, and it is based a lot on cotton. This is what happened in the fixation if you use a super wet or if you don't use a super wet. So the fixation is very intense, and the weight and the fastness on washing, abrasion, all these things is high, very high. That's why since 2006 till today, so since the digital appeared in the market, we lost in Italy only two deals, only two. All the machine, if you come over here, people of, for instance, managers working in Gulag Med, they came over and they spent a couple of days around to see printing house here, and they sold all our machines. So they were very surprised because unfortunately the price does not help us to sell in your country, but the reality is that technically speaking, we are surely considered the number one. Okay, this is what this is what the point number five, and this is the system as I told you to, that we develop in order to control, thanks to this movable chain, to control the rotation of the speed independent of the rod, independently of the translation speed. So we split the two speeds, and you can have a very big steamer which if it is big is also very fast, where anyway the rotation is very slow, very low level of rotation speed in order to avoid the wrinkle of the selvages. So finally, digital printing, dedicated steamer. So flexibility, just in time, small batch, quality, repeatability, and super quick delivery. This is what the customers want now. This is what the market wants now. And this is why we consider our machine the best solution for it. So thank you for your attention. So my presentation is finished. And whatever question you have, Achmed will give you my email address. Now I would be very happy to reply to all your questions here.
Okay. Thank you, Mario. Thank you for your interesting presentation. Now it's time for the question from the audience. So I will ask our Pakistani host, Mr. Javed, sorry for the pronunciation, if he has collected any questions for our panelists. Please, Mr. Javed, you have comments.
Thank you, Mr. Giorgio. Actually, the presentations were very nice. We have some questions, as I can see in the chat room. First question is, I am reading that question. Hi, Mr. Roberto. Please advise if there are some limitations to. I think these are. This question is regarding our first speaker.
Okay.
Yes, I answer in written or by voice.
Yeah, by voice. Okay.
Okay, okay. No, okay. There are no limitation. Of course, depends by the effort that you want to obtain and the process that you want to do. Give you some idea. For instance, if you're making filament fabric, polyester filament, you will not use the brush shredding, you will use the diamond. If you're making some raising, depends by the kind of yarn you're using. So if you want to have a good effect, sometimes use the open end, sometimes not. So real limitations are not present. It's just only to focus on what you want to obtain and the machine to be used, nothing else.
Thank you.
Thanks to you.
Second question is also from Mr. De Grandi.
Yes, it's me.
Is there any specific requirements for fabric in terms of quality for these machines?
Also, in this case, we have to analyze the structure of the fabric and the yarn characteristic. Because if you're using a yarn which is weak, making raising or shredding or what else, you can lose the strength of the fabric. Therefore, also in this case, on the base of the effort that you want to obtain, you have to analyze what kind of structure of fabric you are using. I say. For instance, if you want to have a very, very strong shredding action, you are giving a strong shredding process. But this shredding process may be caused the losing of the strength of the fabric. So at the end, you have to manage the right balance between the kind of yarn, the structure of the fabric, the parameter to be used on the machine. Because you can obtain a fantastic hand, but your fabric lose the strength, the fabric is completely useless. Therefore, there are not limits, it's just only experience of what kind of machine to be offered, what kind of resin fillet, or what kind of brush, carbon, ceramic, or what else, in order to focus on the right behavior, the fabric of the customer on the machine, in order to obtain the best balance between the quality, the strength, and the productivity, of course.
Okay, thank you.
Thanks to you.
The next question regarding the printed yarn, as we have seen in the form of the bobbin. The question is, can you please explain the use of the yarn printed by this technique?
This is a question to me or a
question? No. It's a question
to me, I suppose.
Mr. Beckery.
Yes.
Okay.
There are a huge market in the application of printed yarn. Once could be the upholstery sofa, the fabric for the sofa usually is made by viscose linen, and they make with printed, they do printing just with two colors, shade on shade, darker shade and lighter shade, to have a sort of melange and dark and light effect. Another application is on the terry. I show you the samples, you know, just a special terry fabric, of course, not the commodities terry fabric like we found in the hotel. This is just white. Then another application can be on the knits, garments for active, where they need fashion design with multicolor. You know, this is the, if you go to the mall and you see garments in the mall, in the shops, you see a lot of garments with a lot of colors, or even in the shoes. if you see the nowadays the shoes, sneakers, yeah, the sneakers with that are made with polyester, multicolors. You know, now sneakers are no more white like we had in our ancient time. Yeah? You know, now this.
Okay, thank you.
Yeah, this is.
I want to more curious about this. How a fabric printed by digital printing and the fabric made by this type of yarn, will they look different? Mr. Bakery, can you hear me?
Yes, I can hear you, yes.
Have you listened my question?
No, if you can repeat, please.
I repeat. How will be the difference between the fabric printed by a simple digital printing process and the fabric made by this type of the yarn, the printed yarn,
Yes, in the digital printing, you design a sort of picture. There is a design of on the fabric. Here, in the printed yarn, and when we produce the fabric, we just have a multicolor effect. I mean, there is no design on the fabric.
Okay, another question. The participant did not mention the speaker. Major problem in finishing is staining. How can we solve it? I think Mr. Alex Zuki can explain it. Hello.
What problem you said, Mr. Dr. Javed? Which problem?
Yeah, major problem in finishing, textile finishing, if we talk about textile. Major problem in textile finishing is staining problem. When we wash a fabric, when we wash a printed,
Shrinking.
How can we solve it?
Staining.
Staining.
I suppose they are mentioning the shrinking. Shrinking after
la wash. Colorazione.
After wash, yes. Staining after wash.
Yeah.
Macchie che rimangono.
Cos'è che ha detto?
Macchie che rimangono. Stain.
Non l'ho mai sentito, giuro.
Cambio di colore, cambio virazione del colore, così questo genere. Però disuniformità sul tessuto.
The preparation. The problem is the preparation. When you have these kind of things, it's preparation problem. All the time.
Okay, for next question. We should go for next question. Next question we
consider. Yes, just one second. Mario is right, it's the preparation. Many times it happens that when you prepare the fabric and you're giving some softening or what else, and you are using a padmangle or what else, if the padmangle is not perfectly aligned, is not squeezing on the right weight at the center, the selvage, right, left, and what else, it happens that it remains some more softening or more chemical material inside the fabric in not uniform way. Immediately after that, you don't see it because it's transparent. But when you go on the other process, and could be mechanical process or chemical process, this difference comes out. So when you have staining problems like this, 90% of the time is the preparation of the fabric and the not uniformity of the fabric coming inside the process.
Okay, thank you. For next question with Mr. Mario. What should be steam flow rate in case of conventional reactive printing steaming and in case of digital reactive printed fabrics? Mr. Mario.
Yes. First of all, we have to consider that it depends a lot on the fabric, because you have to consider that, for instance, viscose rayon or man-made fabric, man-made cellulosic fiber absorb more water than just cellulosic. Of course, polyester does not absorb itself water. Then we have the considered twist of nylon, when you have acid or these little things. So that's why when we always say, depending on the cubic meter, arrange. And also depend on the coverage that you have. Depending on the recipe that you have made, how many gram per square meter of printing dye stuff you apply. If you have a huge coverage, imagine you have a complete full black or blue on the background and then you have flowers some way, or you have just, you start from already dyed fabric, because you can start on the dyed fabric and you can just print on it with corrosion, for instance, system. So it depends a lot on how much grams you have to fix it, and the absorption of water made by the fabric, which depends also on the GSM of the fabric and the characteristic of the yarns. As I told you, viscose, for instance, absorb about 15% more water than the cotton, even if they come from cellulose, both of them. But so let's say a 350 meter machine content, which is the average machine, the best seller machine all over the world in terms of steamer. So it's a quite medium big steamer. We go from 750 to 950 kilo of steam, saturated steam per hour. But remember one thing, this is very important for the people is listening to us. I sell also dryer. I was selling for many years a Hyundai machine. In this case, you really care a lot on the consumptions. And this is a parameter in order to decide I buy this machine or the other machine. While you go on the steamer, it's like if you buy a Ferrari to win the, now a Ferrari no more, but anyway, to win the Formula One, and you care about the consumption. No, you want to win. So steamer is a machine which you have to be sure that the fixation is perfect and you need water to do it. Water in the steam. So it's useless to go instead of 750 to 650 cubic meter of steam per hour. And last but not least, Pakistan is made of huge companies where normally they don't know what to do with the steam. They waste it because there is so much steam everywhere. So this is not an issue. But anyway, if they want to know, this is the range. For a 350 meter machine, from 750 to 950 kilogram per hour of saturated steam at 102 Celsius degrees for cotton reactive.
Okay, thank you. One last question. Again, the similar type of question. What will be the steam flow rate pertaining to mainly cotton and viscose with 80 to 100% coverage of design?
Okay. How can I tell you this if you don't know the dimension of the machine? So the flow rate depends on the dimension of the machine. Both dimensions. I mean, how many meters is it inside? Also, how many square meters are inside? Because I can have linearly, I can have 350 meter, but then I have the machine for upholstery is 3.2 working with. And if I'm talking about wool, I have 1.5. So it depends on how many material I have inside. The only thing I can say is that you have about 15% more than what you set for cotton. This is what I can say. That's why before I gave you an idea. 350 meter, 200 millimeter working with. Okay, so you have 700 square meter inside. Okay. And then you use about 750 kilo of steam saturated per hour. Per hour.
Okay, thank you, Mr. Mario.
Let me add one thing only. Super wet system to keep the temperature stable helps also in the steam consumption. We evaluate about 20% less than competition because since we introduce air in the steamer, this is the secret of the superwet, and the air we know is full of steam too. It's full of, there is water in the air. So it means that the steam that we must use is less because we already have this the steam containing in the water, in the air. Especially in country like yours, which very very hot country, especially Karachi, more than Lahore. Of course, you have a situation where the air is quite humid, and this helps also.
Okay, I think it was the last question. Thank you, all the presenters. Thank you, Mr. Giorgio. Over okay. to you, Mr. Giorgio.
So our webinar is over, I think. Thank you all for your attention. Thanks to our panelists and thanks to our Pakistani friends. Let me just say to the Pakistani audience that we see in 2 days, Thursday, next Thursday, for the webinar on garment technologies. And today we are going to send to National Textile University the link to join the mentioned webinar. So thanks to all again, and bye-bye.
Thank you.
Thanks again. Bye-bye.